Hey everyone. Today we have a game showcasing the power of Assassin Irelia. Irelia is back in her set 3 form, where she dashes towards her target and resets on kill. Right now she targets the lowest health enemy, which will definitely get nerfed if Irelia sees a lot of play. Electrocute is just a free win against IE, but it's too early to pick. Let's see what we can do with Assassin Emblems. When I think of potential assassins, I think of champs with AoE like Morgana, or champs with low mana like Vi. I like making Swain an assassin because his spell hits multiple targets. I want to save this glove because I think Affinity Edge is so important for assassins. Swain 2 is a high roll. I probably should have played Arcanist over Talon. I think Swain 2 should have enough damage to win this. Okay, Swain doesn't do as much damage as I thought he would. This guy doesn't have any damage. There's only defensive items left. I'll take Chain for Locket. Echo's our fourth assassin. I don't know if we have enough damage to beat Hextech Bruisers. Locket's a good item to make. Hextech shields are so strong early game. I really want a BF sword for IE. I got perfect AD crit items. I'm gonna go ahead and switch out Swain for Tryndamere. We're just him, but better. Right now I'm thinking about rerolling Tryndamere on 7. Okay, watch Tryndamere absolutely troll this fight. There's a new augment. We're gonna pick it. I'd say it looks better for me. We should be able to assassinate his backline no problem. I'm down to take Kha'Zix for my 6th assassin at 7. Echo 2 is a great upgrade. Why is there a full Morello on this guy's bench? We're just econing here. Left side looks a little bit better. He might have enough damage now to get through Hex Tech Shields. Not sure what items I want. Maybe Chain Vest for Frozen Heart? Warwick is great. Gives Tryndamere Chem Tank and Challenger. We beat the last Hextech guy, but Phalanx plus Hextech Shields are a strong combo. Time to slow roll for some Tryndamere's. Alright, we're being contested on Tryndamere. I'm going to put Blitz in for scrap, keep rolling for Tryndamere. Irelia might be an out. This guy already has Morello Kai'Sa, but no frontline. I'm going to take a sword for BT, just in case we go Irelia. Tryndamere 2 should save us a lot of health until we roll down up 5-1. Tryndamere got enforced. That could be a problem. Electrocute would be really good this lobby. I'm gonna try stacking Cybernetics. What happened to this guy? He has 6 items to my 11. Let's start transitioning to Irelia. We could try running 6 Assassin and 4 Scrap. Rolling down is hard right now. I don't recognize any of these portraits. Probably gonna lose this one. Gotta keep rolling for Irelia too. Server's good for strikers. A lot of people are positioning for assassins. I think Laka gives enough shields. I'm gonna go ahead and swap out 2 scraps for strikers. If I can get to Sivir, I win this fight. IE is perfect to make Kha'Zix my secondary carry. Let's get into 4 strikers and get Irelia on the spotlight. This guy doesn't have a frontline. One reset and Irelia wipes his board. It's not worth putting Irelia in the spotlight if she's jumping on the wrong side. My board's upgraded now. I should win this rematch. These items don't do anything for me. I guess we're just gonna go 9. This guy has shields, but no armor to stop Irelia. I'm gonna move my assassins to jump on the spotlight. Why is this guy frontlining Sivir? I'm just gonna level a 9 for mutants. Having units on my backline forces Jace and Brand to walk up, which gives my assassins room to work. I like RFC for my Gnar. Let's get a mutant for Kha'Zix. My Irelia might get stuck on that bramble. I need to move my Irelia to dodge his. This fight should go better for me. How do we kill that Irelia? That Sivir is really annoying. Keeping Gnar in the spotlight might give consistent non-crit damage to kill Irelia. Gnar is putting in work. That's GG. I'd appreciate any feedback in the comment section. Thanks for watching.